Hey everyone, welcome to Judging for the Win. I'm Dave, and this is my daily ruling. Today's question was suggested by a viewer, thanks to Robert Bowerly for this one. Amy controls Ardenn and Helm of the Host, which is not equipped to anything. Amy wants to have Ardenn equip the Helm of the Host to itself and make a copy of Ardenn. Is this possible? Okay, so for the answer to this question, the first thing I want to point out is that Helm of the Host's triggered ability triggers every combat. It doesn't have some sort of clause in it that says something like, if Helm of the Host is equipped, that would indicate that it only triggers under certain conditions. It triggers every combat, and it makes a token based on the creature that's equipped to. Now, if there is no creature that's equipped to it, it'll have no token. But if there is, then it'll make a token based on that creature. The second point that I wanted to point out is that the ability checks at the time of resolution what that creature is. And so therefore, it doesn't matter if there's no creature equipped to it when the triggered ability triggers, it only matters whether there's a creature equipped to it when the triggered ability resolves. The final point that's important here is that Amy controls both of these triggered abilities, and because they both trigger at the same time, Amy will choose which order they're put onto the stack. This is where Amy has a chance to screw it up. So, if Amy puts it on the stack so that the triggered ability from Helm of the Host resolves first, then when the token tries to get created, there won't be an equipped creature because Helm of the Host hasn't been equipped yet. She needs to put it in the other order so that Ardenn's ability resolves first and she can move the Helm of the Host onto Ardenn. Then, when Helm of the Host's triggered ability resolves, the game will see that there is a creature equipped to it and it'll make a creature token appropriate to that situation. Now, if Nick has some artifact removal spell that he wants to deploy, he can stop Amy from getting a creature token. But, like Amy, there's a chance that he can screw it up too if he doesn't understand how the rules work well enough. The game checks the equipped creature to see its characteristics when the triggered ability from Helm of the Host resolves. Now, if Helm of the Host is attached to a creature at that time, well, everything's good. If Helm of the Host is on the battlefield and not attached to a creature at that time, then there will be no token created. But what if Helm of the Host is not on the battlefield at that time? Well, the game can check back in time and see what the creature that it was last equipped to looked like. If, at the instant that Helm of the Host left the battlefield, there was an equipped creature, the game will use that creature's information to determine what the token should look like. That means that when Nick plays that Shatter, he's going to need to make sure he does it at a time when Helm of the Host is not equipped to anything. If he waits until after Helm of the Host is equipped to Ardenn and then Shatters, the game will use the information based on the creature that Helm of the Host was equipped to the last time it was on the battlefield, and it'll make a token based on that information. So, if Nick plays his spell in the wrong way, then Amy will get a creature token. However, if he manages to destroy Helm of the Host at a time when it's not equipped to anything, then there will be no token created, because the last known information won't have any creature associated with it. And that's all I have for you today. How did you do? Join me again tomorrow for another daily ruling, but until then, I hope you have a great day.